Good morning, and now we're going to start the Welcome to America's Home Cooking. I've already said it to you, so I already assume. We're going to make a one crust for this Spanish pie recipe that I told you I'm going to be making. So we're going to put 3/4 of a cup of white all-purpose flour. Teaspoon of salt. I'm putting kelp in it. They want 1/3 cup shortening. Now I'll be using measuring spoons. It's 5 tablespoons and 1 teaspoon. That makes exactly 1/3 cup. Now we're going to cut the shortening into this until it's crumbly. This actually gives you flakiness to it. Dish 9-inch because I figured there's going to be a volume to it. If I use 9-inch, it'll overflow. So I'm going to actually use a 9-inch, which will make it a little thicker. Because this pie does not have a bottom to it, which is going to be the crust on the top that we're going to do. Tablespoons of cold water, but you only add one at a time and work it in. That's only 1 tablespoon, and now they're going to want a second one. And that's it. Wait a minute, don't put those down there. You're going to need them for the seasonings. And what we're going to do is work this in, get some saran wrap, which you know is wax paper if you're a young person. The older people like me know it is saran wrap. And we're going to put this into a disc, shape it into a disc, and we're going to wrap it in it and put in the refrigerator and let it chill while we do the rest. So let me get my saran wrap cut. I forgot to put the cutter on my saran wrap container, so I have to use scissors and pull it out. Let this get chilled. Let me get the rest of the stuff out and I'll be back. Okay, what they want us to do is, in this frying pan when we get done doing this, they want us to chop the chorizo sausages. They want a half a pound and they want it finely chopped, which I'm going to do right now. It's going to be better if I get it out of the skin. Actually, I think that's exactly what I'm going to do. I did one of those, but I'm not going to do the next one. I'm just going to squeeze this out. I think that would be much better, though. I did chop one up. Do squeeze it out of the casing. I think that would be much better. Bypass the chopping and just sit there and squeeze it out much better. Okay? And they want you to put that, which is a half a pound and 1 pound of ground beef, into a frying pan. They no adding oil, nothing. They just said add it like that. Then what you're going to do with it, they want it to brown.
that off, and we're going to, then while that's going, we are going to chop one medium onion up fine, and a small red bell pepper chopped finely. I'm just not going to pull out a bunch of cutting boards now. These are so tight. I wonder what that means. They're drawing what kind of weather that's going to be. They're really tight. Thank you. when you go to brown meat, put it like on medium high.
Okay. We're gonna get tomato sauce and stuff together. I'll get a measuring cup and a can opener. Tomato sauce. They want 3/4 of a cup. Okay. And they would like we're not going to put this in first. I've got to put the dry ingredients in first, or I'll wet all my measuring cups up. Wet measuring spoons up, I mean. Okay. So let's get these first. All right, chili powder, you're putting 1.5 teaspoons in to the tomato sauce here. Cumin is 1.5 teaspoons as well. And oregano is going to be 1.5 teaspoons as well. Tablespoons. Okay. That's one. Two. Okay, now they want us to drain the sauce, so I've got to get a lid that'll fit this. What is the temperature for this? Hold on, I'm trying to find the temperature to turn the oven on because they want us to turn the oven on. 425. Now what do we want to do with this? Okay. Turn the flame back on. Medium, I'm doing high. Medium high, medium, maybe. Get a fork, we've got to blend all that together and pour it into the meat. We're going to mix all this up, and then they want us to put it into our 10-inch quiche pan, but I don't have that, so I'm going to use my 9-inch deep dish pie pan. Mix this thoroughly together and heat it thoroughly, and then we're going to pour it in to the pie pan, and then we'll get the crust going. Really good. Okay, let me get a few things out of the way. These in here until I get to them. I'm going to cook for a couple of minutes and that's it. And that's just to bring the flavors together. And that's all. Wipe that down. Give me a few minutes. Okay, we're gonna put it in. That's hot. Don't touch it. Put it in your dish. It's quite colorful. Flavor. Okay, we're going to have to move this to the side because we've got to work with the pastry now. And you need an dry counter, board, or something, but it's gonna be dry. You're gonna work with the pastry. We're gonna make a lattice topping. Now, I'm not gonna do it like everyone else. They say, take the strips, fold them back, put them there, then alternate. I'm not doing it that way. I'm gonna show you another way. If you have trouble with lattice toppings like me, I'm gonna show you how I learned. A lot of people avoid putting lattice toppings on, and what they'll do is they'll just put a solid topping on or none. So I know exactly how they feel. I almost feel like this is going to tear. It's showing signs of it. Yes, I could buy pie crust, but I don't like the gum taste in them because that's what they put in it to hold it together. And I don't think gum offers any nutritional value. Oh, the rain. We've had a lot of rain. That's the moisture in the air. I've always told you, that'll dictate it every time. See? So that's what happens when you get a lot of moisture in here. And it's been raining since yesterday, and it's still going to rain, and you can feel it's just all over the place. Mm-hmm. said, I know it's acting up. I can feel it. Strips. Alright, we're just going to start at one end. Make sure you put it in some flour because it's bad when it's weather's been like this. Make sure you do get flour on it and you start cutting strips. If you have to hold it up here to come down and down at the bottom to keep them from breaking, you do that. You just keep on cutting. Try to get them about the same size. If you don't, it's alright. At least you can claim it and say, I did it, and it's homemade. I don't even know if I have enough strips to do this. They want me to do it. But we'll see. I'll just do the best I can. You actually hear is my thinking when I start working and I have problems. I'm actually talking out loud so you can hear how I think, how I'm going to do things. Sometimes when things don't quite work out, you've got to think about how you're going to compensate for it. You don't want to press your knife hard against the counter or your cutting board. You're just cutting through the dough very gently. Because your knife is sharp, you don't want a dull, and you don't want to cut your counter. I'm going to bring you over here as soon as I find room for everything. I'll get a few things. Where did I put them? Okay. I'm going to clean it area and let you fit here. So you can actually, I want you to actually look down and see what I'm doing so you can see. I've got my fingers crossed that it'll work. Okay? So here we go. And wait a minute, we can't put you there, you'll fall in the sink. Okay. Wait a minute, I'm gonna have to turn you some so you can also see the pie, what I'm doing. Okay? That's the best I could do. You're going to use this and pick up one strip. And that's all you're going to do is pick up one strip. Slide it under it. You have to put it on. Now what you're going to do is you're going to lay that strip right there. You see how I laid it? Now watch how I do the second one. You're going to go across it this way. See how it's done? Now watch the next strip. This is how you make a lattice topping without it falling apart. At least I hope they don't fall apart. Lay it this way. Take the next one. And you're going to lay it across here. And you're going to go back on the other side. And you're going to lay it here. See how it's coming together? And tear this off, this little piece off. Try not to break these. Next piece is going to go here. And this is how I do lattice toppings. You know what? I'm going to have to come over here and take the shorter ones. I think, no, I need one more long one. I'm going to put it here. And run it across. I think this one will fit. Yeah, I think I have enough. I have to go on this edge because it's starting to get smaller and I need some bigger pieces for what we're going to do next. Well, that one fell apart. Let's get another one. Go across here. We're going to go across here. And don't worry about the flower, we're going to be brushing them. So the next last one should go here and here. And then we'll do the edging. Right here. Then we're going to put one right there. Push those down a little. You see how I'm pushing them down? All right. Now they want us to put it around the edge here. This is why I didn't know if I would have enough. And the way it was acting, I did not know if it was going to work. They want you to lay this right around. I'll show you. On them. I'm going to lay it on them. Going around in a circle. And try continuing this around without breaking it. Use your hands and just go gently. Okay? I'm not a perfectionist. But I try to make things look appealing. If it's appealing, your family will eat it. All right, let's just break this one in half and get it over here. Okay. That's the best I can do. Now let's get an egg. I'll show you. Let me pick you up so you can look right on top of it. See? See how it looks? Now, when we brush the egg on it, it's going to cover up that flour. So let me get the egg and bowl and stuff and get that going. Want the whole egg or just the white? All right, we want one whole egg. When you beat with an egg, hold your fork at an angle. And come and beat like that, and you'll beat air into it and makes it much easier. It'll actually look like you're making a tornado in your bowl. I'll show you. We'll watch it. When it's getting ready to spin, spin and spin and go around, and you expect it to come up, it won't. That's how you beat an egg. The fork on its side like that, and you're whipping it because there's holes between it. You bring that air, and the egg comes over and starts capturing that air, and that gives it that lightness. Now you're going to brush this. Please do it gently. Find it getting ready to break or stick, just pat it on then. That's how I make a lattice topping. I hope it helps. And it's easier because the other way mine kept on breaking, and I just said this is not working. I got to figure out another way of doing it. And my mother showed me. She taught me a lot of wonderful things in the kitchen. Between Julia Child, James Beard, and her, and my grandmother, and even Nanu. When I was with him, he showed me some things too. And even Gordon Ramsay, these are chefs. I mean, they really. You watch them, they really give you a lot of tricks and ideas and helps your cooking go to a whole new level. I mean, you don't know everything they know because they went to school for it, but if you've learned your basics, you can get a good idea. If you listen, you learn. Julia Child was really an influence on me. I listened to that lady a lot. Well, let me get my recipe and let's see where we're going next. Okay. All right, they say bake the pie until crust is golden brown about 20 to 25 minutes. And then it has to cool slightly before it can be cut or served. Okay, so let's get it in the oven. And time, 25 minutes. Oh, Okay. I will see you then when the pie is done, and we'll see how it comes out. Okay, it's been 25 minutes. We're going to take it out now. Serve it. Most quiches or pies like this, you have to wait. But here it is. That's the pie. And that's how it comes out. So I'll see you in a bit because it has to cool before I serve. I am getting ready to have lunch because I'm hungry. I have been up a long time. And I had a very small breakfast. I only had a piece of toast this morning. So, I'll show you what my dish looks like, and that I do eat the food that I make. If you have any doubts about it, believe you me, I enjoy home-cooked meals. I grew up on them, so has my family, and we enjoy them tremendously. And it's so creative. I've not had this, so this is going to be something new for me to try. This pie is actually a lot of meat, mostly meat. And when you think about it, 3 ounces. 3 ounces is 25 grams of protein, okay? There are 16 ounces in a pound of ground meat. So you divide it. Let's just bring it down to 50. Let's say a pound is 15 ounces, just to make it easy. Multiply 25 grams times 5. You got 125 grams. And this is more than 125 grams because you also added sausage into it and all. So it gives you a good idea how you cook, and you start thinking about meats and your proteins and stuff, it's real easy. But anyway, I'm gonna go gorge myself. So listen, have a lovely day. I'm hungry. I'm gonna go eat. Bye-bye.